I'm Laura Schmid. I am a researcher at the Definity Foundation, and today I'm going to present to you the network nervous system of the internet computer.
So on a high level, the network nervous system, or also called NNS, is realized by a set of canisters, and we will shortly see this in more detail. Now, for making decisions, mainly two canisters are important. The first one is the governance canister, and the governance canister stores two things. First, it stores proposals, which are basically just suggestions how the internet computer should be changed. And these proposals can then be voted on. And second, it stores so-called neurons, which determine who is allowed to participate in governance. The second canister that is important is the registry canister, which basically stores the configuration of the whole internet computer that can then be looked up by others. So it stores, for example, the information that the subnet S3 consists of these four nodes. Next, we will look in more detail what the canisters on the NNS store and how they work. And first, and also as a prerequisite to understand what these neurons are, we will now look at tokens, which are the currency of the governance system. Tokens are managed by yet another canister on the NNS, the so-called ledger canister. And the ledger canister stores two things. First, it stores accounts, and then it stores transactions. An account record keeps track of how many tokens are in the possession of a given principal, and it also denotes an account address. So by principal in this context, I just mean an identity by which a user is authenticated on the internet computer. Tokens can then be sent from one account to another, and this is recorded in the transactions of the ledger canister, as can be seen here on top. Now, as already mentioned, the tokens are the currency of the governance system. And in particular, they can be used for three different things. First, the tokens facilitate participation in governance. Second, both those who participate in governance and those who provide compute capacity by operating node machines are rewarded in tokens. And finally, tokens are used for buying cycles, which are basically the fuel for canisters. So this is the fuel for making computations and storing information. And in the remainder of this talk, we will look at all of these three things in more detail. So first, we'll look at how tokens can be used for governance. So how they can be used to add proposals and to vote on them. We have already mentioned that voting is done based on neurons, and the high-level idea is that those who have more tokens have more voting power. So decisions in the internet computer are made based on a stake-based model. However, neurons do not correspond to tokens, but neurons actually contain locked tokens. So this means that these tokens are not liquid and they cannot be transferred freely to others. So, in more detail, a neuron stores the following information. First, it keeps track of how many tokens are associated with the given neuron, and it does so by just referencing an account on the ledger. Second, it specifies a principal ID, which basically just identifies a public key. And finally, it also specifies a neuron ID that is unique. So actually, there are some other parameters associated with a neuron, and one of the most important ones is an earliest date when the tokens can be unlocked. And the idea of this is that only those neurons who still have their tokens locked for at least 6 months are actually allowed to participate in governance. And this incentivizes the neuron holders to vote such that the value of their tokens are maximized for a future date, and if the value of the tokens is a rough estimate of the network's success, this incentivizes voters to vote in the long-term interest of the internet computer. So, apart from the amount of tokens that are locked in a neuron, the voting power actually also depends on some other factors, but let's just assume for the remainder of this talk that roughly the amount of tokens is the voting power. Controlling a neuron enables users to submit and vote on proposals. And to understand how this works in detail, let's first look at what proposals actually look like.
So this is best done on a concrete example. So let's consider the example of a proposal where it is suggested that a new subnet is created that initially consists of two nodes, the node with ID1 and ID2. So a proposal specifies first a proposal type. And basically, this just describes what this proposal is all about. But technically, this type describes a method in a canister that is to be called if the proposal is accepted. So in this example, if this proposal is accepted, the create subnet method of the registry canister will be called. And to call this method, we also need to know its parameters. And this is what is described in the second line. So here the parameters give the two nodes that should be the initial nodes of this newly created subnet. And also together with the proposal, the governance canister stores how many votes it has already received. So in this example, it already received 250 yes and 100 no votes. Now, let's look at the example where a pink user would like to suggest that a new node should be added to a subnet. Once the user controls a neuron, he can then submit a new proposal by specifying the neuron ID, the type of proposal that he would like to submit, and also the proposal's parameters. So in this example, the user suggests to add a node, so the specified method name is the add node, and the parameters define which node should be added to which subnet. And upon the receipt of this proposal, the governance canister checks that this user is indeed the controller of the neuron and that this neuron is eligible to vote. And if this is the case, the proposal is added to the governance canister. So actually, whenever a proposal is added, the number of yes votes are already set to the voting power of whoever submitted this proposal. So basically, this just means that this proposal already has the support of 100 tokens that are coming from this pink user. So after a proposal is then submitted and added to the governance canister, other users that control neurons can vote on it. And we will here look at an example of an orange user that controls the orange neuron. To vote, a user would first ask the governance canister for the pending proposals to learn what she can actually vote on. And let's just assume that the orange user now would like to reject the proposal that we have just added. So to do so, she would send her neuron ID and a no vote to the governance canister. Again, the governance canister would check that this is the user controlling the neuron and that this neuron is eligible. And since this is the case, it would then add the voting power of the orange user to the no votes. And similarly, other users would also send votes, and let's just assume that at one point, the majority of the voting power is actually in favor of the proposal. So what would then happen is that the proposal will be executed, which means that the described method will be called. So in this example, the add node method of the registry canister will be called with the specified parameters, and the effect of this would be that the node would now be added to the subnet. So the incentive for voters to lock their neurons is actually not only so they can participate in decisions, but on top of that, participation in governance is also rewarded. So this brings us to the second use case of tokens. Rewards depend on different parameters, but one of the most important ones is in how many of the possible decisions a neuron has participated in. And to enable rewards, a neuron actually calls a so-called majority, which roughly depicts how many rewards this neuron has already gained. So this slide only depicts this for the pink neuron, but actually all of the neurons would have such a majority associated with them. And to collect rewards, a user can then do the following. He can send a command to the governance canister to spawn a new neuron, and the effect of this will be that a new neuron with a new associated account on the ledger will be created, and this new ledger account now contains the rewards. So recall that before the majority said that the user has already collected rewards worth 2 tokens, and these 2 tokens are now contained in the new ledger account. And technically what happens if this is done is that new tokens are actually minted and transferred to the new account, and this is also recorded in the ledger canister, as can be seen here. And this new neuron actually has
a small dissolve delay, which means that very soon the user is able to unlock the tokens and use them freely for any purpose that he wants. Now recall that voters want to participate in voting because they get voting rewards. However, it could well be that a user does not have time to participate in all the decisions, and also users might not feel comfortable to make certain decisions. And therefore, the internet computer facilitates liquid democracy. So what this means is that a neuron can specify that it would like to follow some other neurons, which are called the followees, and the governance canister would know this. And whenever a majority of the followees would send the same vote, the governance canister would automatically also send this vote for the follower neuron. So in the very beginning, I said that besides governance participation and voting rewards, tokens can also be used to pay for cycles. And this is the last use case we will now look at. So cycles are the fuel for computation and storage. And actually, each canister on the internet computer, except for those on the NNS, has some cycles stored with it and will use up these cycles, for example, when it performs computations. So the idea why we use cycles for this is that while the token's price may vary a lot over time, the goal of the cycles is to keep the price of the computation power roughly the same over time. So in summary, the network nervous system of the internet computer is a tokenized open governance system that manages the internet computer. Everyone who has tokens can lock them in neurons to participate in governance and contribute to decisions. For example, whether new subnets should be added. And by participating in voting, even if this is done automatically by following, voters get rewards. And they can then spend their rewards or other tokens to pay for cycles, which they can use to fuel the computations of their canisters. And this is basically how the network nervous system manages the whole internet computer.